Chapter 4, The Queen Traps the King. At this point in time, we were 1 year away from the 1800s witch incident. I was relieved how I wasn't under that kind of stress anymore. Dealing with magical people damages my psyche. You don't know what it does to my mind. I get these intense sugar cravings. One thing leads to the next, I start, well, wolfing down all the chocolate and ice cream and candy and, why, the bubblegum at the convenience store near my workplace. Man, good stuff. I get on a sugar high. Then, with a bubble pop, snap and crackle, the inner me comes out. Come to think of it, I don't need any sugar to get this way. I am a wolf after all. In this time, I got my teeth bleached. And a new cable plan. What, you want me to get on with my story again? Why am I always getting distracted? At this point in time, my fortune grew enough that I could become a property developer. What this means is, I used my money to make buildings. I would say build buildings, but that's redundant. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the world of wolf empires. I, however, didn't have that money I needed to do it on my own. I wasn't Donald Trump yet. Have you seen that guy anyway? Is he really a wolf himself? The hair? Oh, it gets me. Makes a guy wonder. In walks this really weird woman. I was confused why I started talking to her one day. Her name was Dora. I asked her why she wanted to talk to me.
I heard you needed an investor for your Central Park West condominiums, she said.
Everything about her was eerie, besides the usual Long Island type of fingernails she wore. She had an accent I could not quite place. I didn't want to ask. She told me,
I am from Salosa, she explained. It's a ritzy suburb in Madrid, Spain.
What can you do with me on my new apartment building? I asked.
I will give you whatever you need for a return in profits.
Fantastic! If you don't mind me asking, what's your purpose?
I am an evil queen. The evil queen of Salosa, to be precise.
What's different about being an evil queen? Thought queens were queens. Have you met Queen Elizabeth II? Or, oh, the Queen Mum way back when? How old are you? I asked sweetly.
Never ask an evil queen her age,
she shouted in my face, striking up her wand at me. Rays of sunshine level pink flew out. I ducked. The rays hit the trash can behind me, turning it into a flock of seagulls. Look, ma'am, that was not cool. I don't know who you think I am, but Flock of Seagulls the song is like nails on a chalkboard to me. You should have turned the garbage can into MC Hammer. Now him, I can groove to. Hammer time. I love his good pants in the music video. Wow, that came out long ago. My uncle danced to it. He was so good, like,
shut up, vile mountain mammal. Will you avoid rudeness?
Yes, ma'am. I was just curious why you are...
An evil queen is different. Queen Elizabeth's mother and met the public. The Queen of England is a pomp and circumstance-level role with Parliament.
You mean she doesn't do anything real?
She makes the people happy. She's a British symbol. I, on the other hand, rule the King of Salosa in Spain. I was supposed to inherit the Spanish throne. They determined I wasn't of a proper place in the bloodline. I'm 5 steps away. As an evil queen, I plot all day and night until I pop every bone in my hands with rage hundreds of times a day. I make other people think I am smart, beautiful, and amazing. Anyone standing in my way gets blown to smithereens. I am not content with greeting the public on ridiculous parades. I will be queen of the world.
You mean like Titanic? Wow.
You have no understanding of what I desire, creature. I want to install
a video game room?
Mind control devices in every book in America. I will control everyone.
What? I laughed. I dropped to the ground as I hit my tummy.
What's so wrong with that?
She said angrily. Your Majesty, nobody who reads books anymore.
Drat, what do you suggest?
She appeared worried. A frown spilled on her eyebrows. Let's use your money together. You rule Manhattan by how much you own, how much you and your products are involved in everyday people's lives. You won't need magic spells. They will love you and admire you naturally for being a successful businesswoman.
I like this idea. You will be my muse.
What does that mean?
You will inspire me with how I can use my money. How do I start?
That's how we met. But knowing you, kiddies, you don't care about the numbers part. You want to know how I meet fairy tale celebrities. Another year passed, voila, my business empire was beginning. The construction on my new Central Park West building completed in record time. The evil Queen of Solosa owned 3 whole floors on top of the place, like a mansion in the sky. Every morning she did her same routine, ending with stepping in front of the magic mirror with a man trapped inside. Elvis Presley, actually. When he died, people spread the rumor about him really being alive. They were right. He never died in 1977. The Queen kidnapped him with a magic spell into her mirror. She laughed away then.
I want to have the most handsome man who's graced the screen and look at him every morning for the rest of my life.
Every morning the Queen asked,
Elvis, Elvis, in the mirror on the wall, who is the fairest one of them all?
Your sister. You've gotten some bit of a tan.
Elvis, darling, I meant prettiest. Who is the most beautiful in all the land? I did not mean literally, literally. The person with the whitest skin.
Oh, my evil lovely, it is you. You are the prettiest in all of Manhattan.
Thank you, Mr. Presley. Thank you very much.
She would say.
Hey, that's my line.
Not anymore,
she told him one-on-one Thursday morning, applying pressed powder onto her face in a handheld mirror.
It's getting boring inside this mirror. I want to write songs, play my guitar, eat a fried banana sandwich, my queen. Are you ever going to let me do anything for one afternoon a week, maybe?
Elvis said.
No,
she said. She draped a floral thing over the mirror.
Oh, not flowered curtains. Oh, they're so 1988.
Elvis could be heard yelling in disgust. You could tell he had it, being trapped inside a mirror. How would you like to be inside one? I cannot imagine it. I already get short-tempered being trapped in a dressing room. Once I set off the fire alarm when I got super stressed when the door would not open on me. And then the fire truck rescued me out of the door. And, oh right, the story, sorry. Friday morning, the Queen's niece, Anna White, aka Snow, was coming back into town. I have no clue as to why her last name was White. Snow has a really obvious fake tan. She needs to be called Snow Crayola Orange. She looks a lot like a stereotypical California beach girl, all long blonde hair and very deep, half-artificial tan. If you ask me, she wears more makeup than my grandmother. Way too much. She was going to college at Harvard Business School, and wham, she graduated Friday morning. Snow was given her nickname as a teenager when she began bleaching her hair on platinum color, almost as white as snow.
Who is the prettiest in all the land?
The Queen said to the mirror.
It's Snow White. She just got into town and wow, she is a little firecracker.
Elvis said.
What did you just say?
The Queen shrieked.
She has returned to town. Snow is a recent Harvard Business School graduate. She moved to New York to find work.
I know that. She's my niece, Elvis. She's not more beautiful than I.
You can get a facial.
I do. Twice a day.
I don't want to lie to you.
How do I rid her from being most beautiful in the land?
You cannot.
My days are darker now. She will never have my throne, nor my beauty. I will kill her.
Why not offer her a home in her native Orange County? Violence is never a good choice,
Elvis told the Queen. She shouted,
It's for me! I will hire a gangster to slit her throat and give me her beating heart in a wooden box.
The evil Queen of Solosa looked in the phone book for a criminal. She didn't know what letter to search for in the yellow pages. Finally, she arrived to letter W, for wicked. Searching all the wicked businesses located in the phone book, including bank robbers, court jesters, anonymous 1960s secret agent film henchmen, and the Pied Piper, she never gave up. Her index finger fell down as she got frustrated. Looking down, The queen saw it at last, an ad with the phone number she was looking for, 1-800-EVIL-HUNTSMAN. The slogan read, "We will hunt and kill anyone you are insanely jealous of. You'll get their beating heart back within 24 hours, or we'll toss in a second beating heart for free."
"Excuse me, is this Huntsman R Us?"
the evil queen of Solosa asked excitedly when someone answered the line. "It sure is. Are you interested in today's special? Get one beaten hot in a box, and three more at half off if you order in the next 15 minutes.
"That sounds amazing. I'll take it."
"Great. Who do you want killed?" the operator asked.
"Let's see. First, my hairdresser. He missed a spot last week. Guy works at Sally Hirschberger's salon in West Village. He should be the only Vladimir there I know of. Unsure of the last name. Second person is this waitress Kelly at this restaurant on 8th and 53rd Street. She forgot my mayonnaise and my cheeseburger and told me I neglected to tell her. The rotten girl did not pay attention. She came back with, get this, 2 sides of ketchup."
"Are you kidding me, lady?" the operator said in a Brooklyn accent. "We had a client last week ask for the heart of a waiter at the same restaurant when he gave him a chicken instead of a steak. You need to write a bad review online about them when we get your waitress's heart back."
"I will."
"That's 2 down. Who are your last 2 picks? You got 1 more heart at a discount and the full price 1 left.
"Oh, why, my final discounted heart. Let me think. Yes, my former 3rd grade teacher. No. He died already of pneumonia. Let's see. I know. My seamstress Jody on Orange Street in Chicago. First, just because he is a man called Jody, he needs to die. Second, he left my dress too high in the back and ripped me off. Charged me more than last time, crook. He's gotta go. His business name is Jody's Big Evil Emporium of Mystical Powered Sewing Professionals and More. The more being the key, he's a crook."
"I feel for you. Who's your last pick? Who's your last pick?"
"Snow White. I want her beating heart immediately," the queen said.
Across town, I didn't know any of this was happening. I was ending a phone call with a business partner in China when my now student interns Hansel and Gretel showed up at my desk unannounced.
"You have a new job applicant. She doesn't have an appointment, but she thinks she would be good for your open position," Gretel said.
"Her name is Anna White. She just got her master's at Harvard Business School," Hansel said.
"Goodness, does it take both of you to tell me that? Hansel, you're supposed to be manning the copy machine. Send her in," I said. Snow, in all her orange tan glory, approached me wearing professional clothes and clutching a resume. A resume is a paper you have that lists all your good stuff. You'll do it when you get older. I began asking her questions after we shook hands and she sat down. "Where do you see yourself in 5 years?" I asked.
"I want to be a strong employee for your new Chinese company, Big Bad Wolf Abroad. I think we could take it further. We could start a Japanese branch called Big Bad Wolf Condominiums Nihon. We..."
"You have a delivery." Someone opened my door. It was the FedEx man. "Great," I said. I signed the package. "Are you Snow White?" he asked. "No, but I don't know anyone here who is. I'll take it," I said. The girl in my office acted fidgety, but she didn't tell me she used that nickname. I read the box. Never heard of this company. Poisoned Fruit of Soho? I shredded the box with my claws, unveiling a shiny, large, strangely waxed red apple, ignoring the job applicant. "Gross. Fruit? I don't think so." I threw it in the garbage.
"Actually, I'm Snow White. Snow is what everyone called me when I began making my hair really light," she said.
"I'm sorry, I can get it back out of the trash for you. I just need to find it underneath my used Band-Aid, earwax, and some stuff I threw in there a minute ago."
"That's alright."
"You sure? Did you know a used Band-Aid only has the same germs as a restaurant kitchen? Oh, and I tossed in a..."
"I really don't want it after it's been in the trash bin. Anyway, I think we could generate..."
"Snow, I think you shouldn't let food go to waste. Kids in other countries don't get any. I'm gonna get it out. Whoa! I shouted. The apple was foaming and was now a small volcano in my trash can. I hosed it down with a fire extinguisher, mumbling,
I cannot believe I almost ate that.
I think it was for me, Snow said.
What makes you think that? I asked.
My aunt is really jealous of me.
I don't know why, I said, still working on putting out the fire. I stomped it with my shoe.
She is Snow White here?
A man with an axe said at the door. He was wearing a weird outfit and looked like a recycled brown paper bag. I sure hope that outfit didn't kill any trees, I told him.
It's cloth, he said.
It looks like paper to me.
No, it's cloth.
Well, it looks like a paper sack. Who makes you wear that?
My company made the uniform. I'd much prefer the one at McDonald's.
Yeah, well, your boss is...
Are you Snow White?
Oh, no.
Have you seen her?
I don't know where Snow is. If I did know who she was, why are you looking for her? Snow asked him.
I got called over by my superior. I'm supposed to slit her throat with this axe and then rip out her beating heart with my bare hands. I'll probably use a staple, though, and tell my boss I did it with my bare hands. Do you guys got any office supplies I could borrow? Makes my job easier.
Well, in that case, I think I saw her going into another office. The floor below, I think? Snow said.
Snow, the man is being sarcastic. Sir, that's Snow White. Her real name is...
Wonderful to meet you, my dear. Would you excuse us while I go use my axe on her?
He asked.
Sure, make sure not to dirty my new carpet on your way out. You know how white stains the most.
Excuse me? Snow yelled at me. Wolf, I'm gonna...
The huntsman scooped her up in his arms. Snow screamed wildly as he walked with her out the door.
Aren't you going to stop him? Hansel asked. You have no morals.
No, I said. And she's a nobody. Anyone receiving flammable apples is a bad person to hang out with.
Aladdin, her aunt is the evil queen of Solosa. You need to rescue her.
You're right, intern child. I need to keep my investor's family safe. I don't want anyone killed. What was I thinking? Oh yes, about how I could use a chocolate fruit cake. Mmm, finger licking good. I'll crumble it, swirl it in my mouth, let the chalk...
They're in the elevator by now. Go after them,
Hansel said. I ran down the stairs to the lobby, half expecting the huntsmen to have gotten Snow by now. I stopped, eavesdropping on their conversation, when I saw them nearby on the first floor.
The queen also gave orders for your lungs and liver. I'm kind of grossed out. I've never done that before,
the huntsman said.
Oh, dear huntsman, don't kill me. Leave me with my life,
Snow shouted. I will run into the subway and hitch a ride to Madison Square and never come back.
Yeah, White, but what's the boss gonna say when he sees you free? That stuff only works in old fairy tales. This here's the real world.
Please don't kill me. I'll give you some money to buy a heart, lungs, and like a gross cow liver at a butcher shop,
Snow told him, sobbing.
Okay.
The huntsman put her down and Snow gave him a few $20 bills from her wallet.
Man, that was cool. I was scared, I said, coming out from behind the elevators.
Thanks for not saving me. What good is a wolf when he acts like a chicken? She said. I don't have enough bad words in my vocabulary for what you are. No, I do. I really cannot tell you what else she said. You may gladly learn some of those words from R-rated movies when you are older, but please don't use them.
Fine, Snow, I replied when her rant ended.
You're welcome to call me a coward in words with many inappropriate meanings that I cannot repeat on paper when I write my memoirs. It doesn't excuse you from being a spoiled brat. I was interested in you as a job applicant, but I'm not anymore. I'm going to put in a bad word about you if I learn you are working on...
I'm sorry, I got carried away.
You better have a good apology. You need to apologize for the mean things you said about me getting poisoned with that fruit and bringing potentially convicted felons into my plush Wall Street offices. That guy almost stained my new carpet with your blood until I told him not to do it. Have you any idea how much that flooring cost me? An arm and a leg. I digress.
You're more worried about the carpet than someone taking my life?
No, equally worried. I'm sorry, I mean, almost equally. Well, it was expensive. I naturally am conservative about how I spend my money wisely. I got here for that very reason.
but I did worry about you. I don't like anyone getting killed, and definitely not by a guy in a paper sack. Let's take you home to your aunt.
I guess we should go, Snow said. I called my chauffeur immediately, as we rode in the limousine up to my new condos, where the queen lived, if you forgot. She fell asleep. I blasted the radio to wake her up. She told me more foul words I cannot repeat. I get a kick out of teasing people. I'm a wolf, remember? When we arrived, 7 short men, and I mean obscenely short, maybe 2 feet tall, mobbed us. I'm not signing autographs, I told them. I get bugged by fans. Normally I don't mind, but sometimes I'm off to a business meeting, you know?
We are here for Snow White, a dwarf said. If you will keep house for us, Snow, and cook, make beds, wash, sew, and knit, and keep everything clean and orderly, then you can stay with us. You shall have everything that you want.
Not in this century, I told them. Security, please keep these creepy men away from us, I told my bodyguards in the van behind me. Snow and I ran into my condo development.
Don't be mean to the dwarves, she told me.
Those dwarves are so weird. Do you know them? I asked Snow as we walked into the building elevator.
Yeah, they're former friends of mine, really. And, okay, they mean well. The dwarves really, like, only get noisy. They're sweet guys at heart, since I was Miss Malibu, USA. The dwarves, want me to move in with them, though, to support their rent. I'm not going to have 7 guys not paying rent. They all go to NYU, much too young for me to hang out with, to begin with. I like shopping enough that I don't need to live with anyone. I do not require socializing.
Figures, you're kind of...
I'm kind of what? You're so...
You kind of have an unfriendly chip in your personality.
Oh hey, we arrived, I said, innocently changing the subject when I saw her scowl.
We walked to her aunt's apartment and knocked on the door.
Aladdin, so good to see you, she said from behind the peephole. I'm having a marvelous day. I just had my chefs cook the lungs, heart, and liver of my niece, Snow White. I'm now the fairest one of all. Come in.
As she opened the door, I said, I don't get it. Did Snow give you her organs? She's safe and sound here. She was. Snow seemed to have gone hiding.
What do you mean? The queen asked.
She's... Oh, there you are, Snow! I said, noticing she was running down the long hallway. She's running away for some reason. I don't get it.
I'll see about that. You stay in my apartment, dear, she told me as she ran after Snow.
Inside, I sneezed when I smelled garlic. There, on the living room coffee table, was a half-eaten hot on a paper plate. I sniffed it. It was most certainly human. I checked the Chinese restaurant-style carry-out box. Vladimir. Who's Vladimir? I asked aloud.
I will tell you if you let me out of this mirror, a familiar voice said.
Are you the genie I met? You led me into making wishes I did not want.
I'm Elvis Presley.
No, you're dead.
Lift up the curtains here, and I shall show you.
Sure thing, I told the voice. I saw the king in my reflection. Cool.
I was trapped in this mirror many years ago by the queen. Today she ordered the beating hearts of several people. Your friend Snow is in danger.
She isn't my friend. I just met her today. Wow, I must be getting less desperate. I now know the difference between friends and acquaintances, I told him.
The queen wants to eat her heart out. You need to rescue her.
I'm such a fan of your work. My favorite song of yours is Jailhouse Rock.
Thank you very much. But I've got no time for flattery. You need to bust this mirror and rescue me and Snow, Elvis said.
How do I do that? I asked.
You think I'd be asking you that if I knew how?
I know. I'll break the mirror.
You'll kill me and from breaking the mirror have 7 years of bad luck.
Well, if you want, you can transfix your spirit into my body. Whoopi Goldberg did it in Ghost.
It's a movie that came out a decade after you got trapped in the mirror.
Okay, think, Aladdin, think, I said.
Ah, the password is Open Sesame.
Good grief, Elvis said. Okay, I give up. I'm gonna get food.
A banana sandwich?
A burrito, I said.
Suddenly, the mirror crumbled, fireworks exploding in rainbow colors. Weird. Burrito failed me for the money tree cave place. Open Sesame was the password there. So some dumb people do use burrito as a password. Who cares? We need to go rescue Snow! Elvis shouted at me. He looked like his old movies, the young Elvis. I'm gonna need a bucket of water, I said. It'll melt her.
She's a queen, not a witch, Elvis said. I've got it. Round her up. I have a plan.
I took off my dress shoes and ran after the queen on all fours. She was in the middle of chasing Snow up and down the stairs, apparently. When I caught her, Elvis threw his queen-cursed shoes at me. When I forced them onto her feet, the shoes burned like a hot oven. She started dancing.
What is this?
She yelled as she danced in circles with her pelvis shaking moves. They're the shoes you cursed when you trapped me in the looking glass, Elvis shouted from a flight of stairs above us. 10 seconds later, she danced herself ablaze. Then she crumbled into a pile of ashes.
Woohoo! I'm rich, like billions rich, Snow said. She left me all her money in the will.
She danced around in a circle. Snow, quit your rain dance. Why would she do that? And the apartment. Why, if she wanted to kill you? She assumed I'd die first, Snow said. Did she ever spend any money on anything positive? I asked curiously.
No, she's been trying to kill people all her life. Burn their beautiful faces, the usual stuff crazy aunts do.
If you don't use your money to better yourself or your business, at some point in time, it all goes to waste. Hasn't she ever heard the phrase, it takes money to make money?
Nope, Snow said. Mr. Jackson, Aladdin, what am I gonna do next? I don't want to end up like her.
Why, we can turn your story into a movie. It'll be produced into a live action, a cartoon, everything. You'll have a big plot on your hands. Can I do the licensing? Option it to film companies and market via my public relations firm? I asked. When you have a negative event in your life, never let it get to you. Use it as inspiration. Earn money while you can. As the other saying goes, make lemons into lemonade. Snow worked with me on her project. It was eventually picked up by Hollywood. She also went on to star in many more non-film projects, including her reality show, The Real Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. It really is all who you know. The other thing I did was realize that no networking opportunities ought to go wasted. So few people or wolves get to meet supposedly dead iconic celebrities, much less build relationships with them. I worked out a business arrangement with Elvis. We decided to stage his comeback over the next month until he came out with a bang on the morning news show. All in a day's work. All the absence had left him with a brand so powerful, not even a magic mirror could prevent him from selling records. And I was going to ensure that he was back in the music game.